Okay, if you're watching this video, then it's because your warranty's expired, you can't afford a new engine, or you want to make this repair easy. Now, before you begin, make sure you called your local Honda dealer and made sure you're not under warranty. I do not recommend this method because I am using JB Weld, but I am going to see how it goes. So if you're still watching, let's begin. We're going to start by lifting the car. So make sure you pull the e-brake and block off the wheels. To lift this vehicle, you want to position the jack right there. Let me see. Right there where I'm pointing. Position the jack right there. Now position your jack stand right under the pinch weld. Side of the car and do that on both sides. We're gonna be taking off the exhaust manifold, so make sure you use some kind of penetrating fluid. Okay, so this is where I was telling you to jack up the car from. What we're gonna do is we're gonna wet these bolts down. As you can see, the car hasn't moved in a while. We've got a lot of spider webs, but there should be, I believe, 4 bolts. There's this one right here, this one, and this one. Then you want to take out this oxygen sensor. Don't do what I did and bend it all up. I couldn't get an oxygen sensor removal tool or a socket, so I went ahead and bended it, but don't do this. If you could find one and take it off the proper way. Want to plug that and take these 3 bolts out. Should be 1, 2, 3. Okay. By the way, this is a socket I was saying. I do have one, but what I meant was that it's too fat up here. So when you buy one, make sure it's thinner so it can fit on that shield. Now that you got the cover out of the way, you just want to spray these 4 bolts. And you'll take off the 4 bolts you previously wet right here at the bottom. You want to do this first so it's not so hard to grab the catalytic converter when it comes down. You unplug the other oxygen sensor. And then now we can take these 2 bolts out up here. We'll take the 4 bolts out from the top. Once you get those bolts out, you want to just move it a little bit. As you can see, I'm turning another bolt down there, and it'll get this bracket out of the way because it is gonna be in the way. And now you should be able to slide it out. Once you have the manifold out of the way, you just wanna cover the exhaust so nothing falls down there. And then you might want to clean it off a bit. We're going to use a radiator pressure tester. We're going to go no more than 15 psi. If you don't have one of these, you can go ahead and rent one from your local auto parts stores. Now I can see where mine is leaking out of, so make sure you pinpoint where it's at and we can go from there. Well, you can really see it now. And I'm gonna go ahead and use a wire brush to roughen it up a little bit. Then you roughen up the surface with the piece of sandpaper. So now we're gonna mix our JB Weld. Okay, I put 2 layers on mine. I let one dry for an hour and then I put another one. Let this dry for a day and then before putting everything back, just to make sure you're not gonna hit anything. Once you got that JB Weld on, you just wanna put everything back. I would suggest starting from the bottom. Do not tighten anything until everything is straightened out down there. The easiest part is going to be up here. change these gaskets out. I didn't just because I don't know if it's gonna work, but if you want to, you can go ahead and let's give this a shot. And of course, plug your stuff in. What you want to do next is put your heater all the way up, max, and then you'll fill it up with coolant. In my case, we're gonna use distilled water because we don't know if this repair is really gonna work or not. Okay, so I ran the engine, drove it around a while. Seems to be holding on, but I'm not sure how long it's gonna be till it goes out again. So like I said, I don't recommend this, but it is working for me for right now. But I'll be making an updated video to see how it goes, and if it goes out, how long it went out, or how long it held. But I'll let you guys know.